Hello, in this video, we will look into how does Wi-Fi work. A lot of people may know how Wi-Fi works as we use it daily in our smartphones, laptops and everywhere in form of hotspots. But the technology behind and some of the geeky knowledge behind this might not be known, for which you'd like watching this video to know about the technology. And Wi-Fi is popularly known as wireless networking technology, and it is everywhere. It can connect telephones, smartphones, laptop, computer, and everything you can imagine can be connected today with Wi-Fi. And Wi-Fi stands for wireless fidelity. The Wi-Fi was invented by NCR Corporation, also AT&T, in 1991, and it's a technology by using which we can exchange information from one device to the other, and the information between two or more devices. It's essentially a technology which in today's world is used to connect smartphones, mobiles and laptops and many other gadgets to each other, also through internet to these devices. The wireless network or a Wi-Fi operation has three essential elements. One is the radio, other is the antenna, and or the router. So there is a radio signal which has a propagation limitation in Wi-Fi is close to 100 to 150 feet. The radio signals are transmitted from antennas and routers. That signals are picked up by Wi-Fi receivers such as computers and cell phones that are ready with Wi-Fi cards. Whenever they come in a range or signal range of 100 to 150 feet, for router it connect the device. So that's basically how Wi-Fi works as we know. Getting more into the technology of how Wi-Fi works, if you see, the Wi-Fi uses radio signals in two main frequency bands. They are 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. One interesting thing about these frequency bands are that they are free for use by anybody. Anybody can communicate in the 2.4 or 5 GHz bands, and these bands has different channels, and these are unlicensed bands, which means that it is not controlled by any agency and no license to or permission to use these bands are required, and it is not controlled by agencies such as FCC and other international and national government bodies, and they have decided that anybody can use this without any permission. So coming to the Wi-Fi which we know, the Wi-Fi which we know from our smartphone are hotspots. So what is a hotspot? A Wi-Fi hotspot is created by installing an access point to internet connection. Access points are base stations that can connect one or more device simultaneously to internet. Single access point can connect up to 30 devices in 100 to 150 feet range. So Wi-Fi cards help to accept signals to these access cards. So what does an access point do? The access point feature radio transmitter and antenna which facilitate connectivity between devices and the internet or a network. A access point is also known as hotspot. So what you know as a hotspot is essentially a access point. If you look at the diagram of the technical diagram of how Wi-Fi works, so this is the access point is a smartphone here, and they are also known as base stations, and this access point will transmit the Wi-Fi which shows the signal circle, and it can be received by a tablet which is having a Wi-Fi card installed in it. So that's how a simple Wi-Fi working you can imagine. So there is also another kind of network which is known as ad hoc network. An ad hoc network don't require an access point and it don't require connection to the internet. An ad hoc network directly transfers information from one device to another using Wi-Fi. So the tablet to smartphone file transfer using any application can be an example of an ad hoc Wi-Fi connection. If you look at a more complex connection, then you can see that how a router is connected. If you imagine that the router is connected to a LAN, which is a source of internet, and this router will be connected to a bridge, and this bridge will be connected to access points, which are emitters or internet Wi-Fi, and this access point also control how other devices are connected to the internet. So using the access points, different devices like laptops can be connected. Also, the range of the Wi-Fi can be extended by using overlapping access points. So that's all about knowing the basics of Wi-Fi and how Wi-Fi works at the basic level. If you like this video, also moving further, you can see that there are four major types of Wi-Fi technologies, that 802.11a that defines the format and structure of radio signals, 11b supports bandwidth up to 11 Mbps, 11g supports up to 54 Mbps, and 11n supports up to 100 Mbps. Also, Wi-Fi has a security key authentication. In this authentication mode, both sides of the connection know the value of a shared secret key, and using the knowledge of which the connection is established. This is a basic security which most of Wi-Fi today uses. That's all. If you like this video, please do subscribe, like and comment.